I think as far as physical autonomy is concerned, I would sort of rank the domains in terms of the difficulty of developing autonomy in them, and basically say air is sort of easier, sea is a little bit harder, and then ground has been very difficult.
I think we're going towards unmanned systems, more autonomous, faster decision making, but I still hope human will be in the loop.
In 5 years, so we're not talking the far future, but just in 5 years, where is the US military with AI? So we've talked a lot here about where we are with AI right now. I think the biggest question for everyone involved in this is, where is AI going to? And what the end game of this all looks like. And Sydney, maybe I'll start with you. Where are we going?
I think for the United States in particular, and actually probably China to the degree which we can understand from the outside what they're doing, we're going to see really dramatic progress in AI for some of the back office and sort of military staff functions. All the functions which kind of map to the commercial world, we're dealing with huge amounts of data from whatever source, right? It's people putting things in their Amazon carts or satellites detecting, you know, torpedo boats coming out of Chinese harbor, right? Ultimately, the algorithms don't care and don't know the difference, but they can find patterns, match data, and highlight things to the human who's making the decisions. And the American CJADC2 system, which parts of which are actually up and running, is very much about trying to do this. There's a spinoff of that called Joint Fires Network. So it tries to do that for finding targets for long-range strike, be it by aircraft or by missiles. There's logistical systems for so-called contested logistics in the Pacific, trying to move supplies efficiently from the U.S. to the front without getting them blown up in the process. And that kind of planning function, that kind of efficiency streamlining function, I think actually has a lot of near-term potential, in part because it's so similar to a lot of what the commercial world does. I think the hard part is AI that navigates in the physical world. And trying to get physical robots to move through the ground or even in the air under sea has proved a lot harder. I mean, the Navy just had issues with two of its drone boats colliding in one exercise. So I expect to see a lot of the back office kind of Amazon recommendations, except for bombing things, to move ahead. I'm very much more doubtful about the killer robots and Terminators actually materializing.
Well, there are definitely limitations. Otherwise, we would already see ground robots, etc. But, you know, the practice and real battlefield will actually show what's working, what's not. But I do agree on the general concept that we will still get more unmanned, and these unmanned systems will become more AI enabled. And it's up to us to decide to which extent they're autonomous, to which extent we allow them to make decisions. I don't think that they might work in the same way efficiently through different domains, etc. But I think it's just a matter of time for us to see that these systems can perform in different domains and actually achieve their goals. All of this will increase the pace of war. So definitely this analysis will be faster when we come to CJADC2 dream, and we will integrate everything. Everything will talk to everyone. It will become seamless, etc. The pace will be really, really fast. But I think humans still will be in the center, like with CCA, for example, or any, basically any mission, because still, like, even in Ukraine, you can see flying drones, I don't know, crawling drones, but still there is an operator who actually controls all of them. There is a fighter jet which controls the systems which fly around it and navigates. So the battlefield will show which systems are effective, which are not. And that will be like a natural organic filter, what will stay and what will go away. When I talk to the military and I'm like, when we're going to switch to AI-enabled decision-making or agentic functions, for example, they're like, you know what, we first need to be ready for this. For example, we need to make our processes digital. We need to prepare the data. We need to prepare the infrastructure. And again, I'm working on Ukrainian case and Ukrainian war. And Ukrainian Minister of Defense started with digitalizing their processes, just usual business processes, requests from soldiers to transition to another command, for example. It previously it's been completely paperwork. So basically, you have to write a paper, it takes an hour, you have to deliver it 100 kilometers away to another command, and then it goes to the general staff, etc. They're like, if AI could just fill this report and write it for us and send to our commander for approval, that would make our life so much easier and safer, because to bring that paper from the front line to a command center, that's also dangerous. So I think the first level and layer in this situation is to be prepared in terms of digital infrastructure, and then build on top of this small little solutions which tackle small little problems, agents which solve small little problems, and then unite them and gather into something bigger, decision-making system, which would be the ultimate goal probably. But I don't see it coming anytime soon. I think we're going towards unmanned systems, more autonomous, faster decision making, but I still hope human will be in the loop, and people will make decisions, final decisions on kinetic action, actually.
So Josh, I'm going to put you on the spot. You're the lucky one. I want you to predict in 5 years. So we're not talking the far future, but just in 5 years, where is the US military with AI?
Yeah, so I think to echo as a starting point a little bit of what Sydney was saying, I think we can assume a lot more integration with these back office functions. I think we can assume that there's going to be a lot more experimentation with LLMs for things like generating reports, for maybe doing some intelligence analysis. Mm-hmm. I think as far as physical autonomy is concerned, I would sort of rank the domains in terms of the difficulty of developing autonomy in them, and basically say air is sort of easier, sea is a little bit harder, and then ground has been very difficult. We just know it's a cluttered environment. It's difficult to operate in. It's very dynamic. And so I would say I would expect to see more and more of these air systems developing, right? We have CCA. People are talking about this. We've had DARPA ACE for, I believe, 6 years at this point, and that's continued to develop. So we certainly see developments in that domain. I would assume we're still going to be pretty close to these rule-based systems, these ones that are essentially carrying out what you can imagine is decision-making logic that's been pre-programmed. That is considered a type of AI, but it's obviously very different from what we're talking about with some of these LLMs when you're starting to step into that agentic space of actually receiving a really high-level input and turning that into a plan and actually executing it. I don't think we're close to that in the next 5 years.
The thing about AI to date is it is very brittle. Either it's that sort of first generation expert system, if then or else, where a human expert or team had to come up with all the possible variations and how the computer should react to them, in which case there'll always be something you didn't think of, right? It's actually a law of the universe. It's Gödel's incompleteness theorem. You will never think of all the options. It's not mathematically possible. Or it's these neural nets, the so-called second generation AI that are powering chatbots, powering Amazon recommendations, that are really powerful at finding patterns in data that is similar to what they were trained on, but are very prone to breakdown if you ask them to analyze something that's even slightly different. For whatever reason, neural nets, though inspired by the human brain, haven't achieved anything like the human capacity to generalize, right? If a little kid pushes their oatmeal bowl off the table 100 times, they figure out the gravity works. The AI, we need to do that a billion times to figure out the gravity works. We don't know why they're so much slower at learning. And so it's very possible for AIs to break when they're used on data that doesn't match their training data, when an adversary has deliberately given you false data, for example, by training in peacetime in a way that deliberately doesn't reflect what they're going to do in wartime, using different frequencies, using different tactics, and making sure you see that and train on that. Or even by inserting random bits into the data stream that a human wouldn't notice, but that AIs will detect and mistake for significant information. There have been cases where, putting a few strips of reflective tape on a stop sign caused the AI for a self-driving car to think it was a speed limit sign, right? No human would be fooled by that, but somehow these very small changes in the data set caused a massive misinterpretation by the AI. And until we fix that, we're kind of stuck with humans babysitting these things so they don't go literally off the rails.